The problem is that the physical culture people believe that the obstacles are external. So they're working out. Saw a guy, he's running up the mountain. I ran down the mountain. Not supposed to, but I felt I could do it. They're preparing to combat external obstacles, called physical obstacles. And problem with the spiritual materialists is they think the problem is internal. And so they're working on all this internal meditation, all this kind of stuff. But truth is, the obstacle is neither external nor internal. There is no obstacle. Let me see. There is no obstacle. There are no obstacles. And this is the realization. There's no I. There's no hero. There's no one that finds the self. There's no obstacle to finding the self. So how can there be someone who finds the self? The self is not hidden at all. So this is what Buddha realized, is he did the meditation thing. And he said, I'm trying to overcome obstacles, internal obstacles. And he said, that's not it. And then he said, okay, I need to overcome the obstacles of the body. So he did all this rigorous asceticism. And then he discovered that's not it either. And then he realized, oh yeah, there are no obstacles. And so this is the baffling situation. We find ourselves in this realm where people are trying to decide which way do we go. Do we go for the physical stuff, or we go to the spiritual stuff? And what we say is there isn't any stuff at all. This is the Nyingma Master Dzogchen Adepts, Pama Sangha Longchenpa Jemyang Kenchi Choki Lodro, etc. This is what they're conveying. This is the true non-dualism. It's not either one. There's nothing to overcome. Yeah. So it's just a matter of getting familiar with this. Keep hearing it, keep getting familiar with it. And in the meantime, when in Rome, do as Romans do to a certain extent. There's nothing wrong with a little meditation. There's nothing wrong with a little workout. It's okay. It provides a little bit of continuity, security for being in the world, right? Yeah, it does. Because the problem is our continuity fear. We want to feel smooth. We don't want to feel abrupt transitions, realization, and coming back into the world of functioning here. If you're in shape, if you're on a good diet, etc. It seems like, oh yeah, I could just, you know, keep my stride going here, realizing there are no obstacles. At least you appear like you're tackling obstacles, you see. you don't want to appear like, you know, too, like Padmasambhava in today's world. He's not getting much traction. But you might appear like him, but so I'm doing this, little bit of this, little bit of that, and keeping up appearances. Especially don't want to fall into the meditational yoga girl things, spiritual materialism, trying to conquer inner obstacles. Which, if you have a real certain type of mind, it's easy to get into that, right? So the Holy Spirit has me working out. I say, what are you doing? I thought we need to be, you know, looking within. there's actually no looking required. It's when we stop looking, either within or externally, that we are able to recognize, oh, you know, everything is me, is what I am. We cannot put it in words, but when we stop the search, that's when we realize, hey, I don't need a search for what I am. I can't lose myself. It's impossible. The shade is nice. A little bit of shade, a little bit of sun. So I just keep working on those aspects because I'm aware that these are the snares. So what did I have last night? Apple, juiced up an apple, and a bunch of kale, and some tart cherry juice. That was my evening meal. It's like, wow, you know. Well, blueberries, I threw a bunch of blueberries in there too. That was good. But it really doesn't mean anything to me, except I'm kind of aware of the yoga girls, and you know, they'll have you collecting weeds out in the garden, and it's, you know, this green stuff, green slime, that's, you know, that'll cure everything that's wrong with you. And that can become, you know, you can feel, okay, good, I'm conquering some obstacles this way. What obstacles does the self have to knowing what it is? Nothing but hallucinations, fantasies, ridiculous absurdity. Okay. You have to realize the sky-like nature, intrinsic spaciousness. There we go. All right, as they say, very great.